Today, I'm going to talk about what you need to know about histamine intolerance and probiotics, so stay tuned. If you're new here, hey there, my name's Amanda Malicheski. I'm a certified functional nutrition health coach and a digestive and allergy detective. For tips and tricks on how to eat without triggering your symptoms and how to restore your gut, please consider subscribing and be sure to hit the bell to be notified when I post a new video every week. Lots of people report histamine reactions when they take probiotics, so I wanted to talk today about what to do in this situation. So by the end of today's video, you'll know why probiotics might cause this reaction and what to do about it. Let's get started. Let's start by defining histamine intolerance. Basically, histamine intolerance is when you have a reaction to either histamine foods or to something that's triggering a histamine response in your environment, things like dust or pollen. Usually, histamine intolerance is a symptom of something bigger. In my experience, it's usually showing that there's some sort of bacterial imbalance in your gut. There's an environmental trigger like mold or pollen or dust or something like that in your environment, or it's that your body is lacking some of the nutrients it needs to break down histamine in the body. I'm sure that you're aware that probiotics are a really great tool for helping to restore your gut environment. And if you'd like to learn a little bit more about that, you can check out my earlier video, 3 Best Probiotics for Gut Health. I'll leave a link for that below this video. But some people react to probiotics, and this reaction can look an awful lot like a histamine reaction. Like, has this ever happened to you? It actually happens for me. And what happens for me when I take the wrong probiotics is I get itchy in my ears and in my throat and in my head. And I also may have some bloating or even some diarrhea. So what now? There's a couple of reasons why this might be happening with your probiotics. One common reason is that sometimes probiotics have prebiotic fiber included in the capsules. And prebiotic fiber is basically food for bacteria. So if you have an overgrowth of bad bacteria and you eat probiotic fiber, this extra fiber can feed your bad gut bacteria. If bacterial overgrowth is one of the reasons that you have histamine intolerance to begin with, this feeding of bacteria can actually make histamine symptoms worse. Another potential reason is that certain probiotic species are actually histamine producers. So if you're eating a probiotic supplement that has some of these probiotic species in them, you may be increasing your population of bacteria that produce histamine. And some of these species are, and I'm going to look down to read this for you, Lactobacillus brevis, Lactobacillus bulgaricus, Lactobacillus casei, and Lactobacillus reuteri are some of the common probiotic species that can trigger a histamine reaction. So if you're using probiotic products with these species in them, you might have a negative reaction if you already have a histamine problem. One further reason may be just that your body doesn't need that particular type of probiotic right now. In this case, maybe as you add that probiotic, it's destabilizing your gut environment such that it's leading to more histamine for reasons unknown. The most common type of probiotic that triggers these kinds of reactions are the Lactobacillus and Bifidobacterium blends, which are really the most common type of probiotic. And chances are, if you've bought probiotics at your grocery store, these are the types of probiotics that you've purchased. The good news is that there's 2 other types of probiotics that you can try if you find that you're reacting to these other types of probiotics. So the other 2 types are either Saccharomyces boulardii, which is a beneficial yeast, or soil-based probiotics like the Megaspore Biotic product that you may have heard about. You can also try using a lacto-bifido blend probiotic product that doesn't contain those species I just mentioned a few minutes ago. One that I've found that I use for my clients is the Claire Labs Metabolic Blend, and it just doesn't contain any of those histamine-producing bacteria. As with any supplement or intervention, you want to be really mindful to listen to the feedback that your body's giving you. No matter what product you're trying or diet change or anything, if your body's giving you feedback that it's not working for you, then that's something you probably should discontinue and move on to something else. If you feel a lot worse from using a particular probiotic, you can try to use one of the other 2 types of probiotics and see if you do better. But if your body says no, then your body says no. For more about how and when to use probiotics, you can check out my earlier video, When to Use Probiotics for Gut Health. Have you found that you react to probiotics? Tell me about it in the comments. So that's what you need to know about histamine and probiotics. If you'd like, you can set up an account in my supplement dispensary to see which specific products I recommend for my clients. I'll be sure and leave a link for that below this video. If you're having histamine symptoms and you're still not sure how to improve them, there's two main ways that I can help. The first is you can download my gut guide called the Roadmap to Gut Recovery. It gives you the same process that I use with my private clients to help them work towards remission or symptom relief. You can download a copy of that for free by visiting confluencenutrition.com/roadmap, and I'll be sure to leave a link for that below this video. Or if you feel like you've already tried a lot of stuff and you're feeling really confused about what to do next, I encourage you to set up a free 30-minute assessment session with me. I'll be able to help you get a sense of what your next best steps would be, and we can talk about what it would be like to work privately one-on-one together. You can do that by heading over to confluencenutrition.com/contact. I hope that this video helps you move your gut healing forward and helps you use probiotics with less side effects. If you like this video, please consider liking and sharing with your friends and family members who could benefit. I would greatly appreciate it, and I look forward to seeing you next time.